we have when we're drafting up the legislative amendments. Thank you.
Government Bill, first reading. Construction Industry Security of Payment Bill, second reading. The Secretary for Development. President, I move the second reading of the Construction Industry Security of Payment Bill. The bill seeks to improve contractual payment terms, establish an adjudication mechanism to resolve disputes quickly, and grant unpaid parties the right to suspend or slow down the progress of work or services under the circumstances in order to improve the delayed payment problems among stakeholders along the construction industry supply chain, which have existed for a long time, and reducing the likelihood of non-payment wages to construction workers. Construction work covers a wide scope and it involves a variety of professions or trades. The work has unique features, making it difficult for an individual contractor or consultant to undertake an entire project. To enhance the flexibility in project procurement, subcontracting arrangements are common in the local construction industry. Various contracting parties are involved, including clients, contractors, subcontractors, suppliers, consultants, and so on. If a party delays in payment, it will pose financial pressure on various stakeholders along the supply chain, especially the small and medium-sized enterprises with relatively low financial risk tolerance level. Payment problems may also lead to project delays and disruptions. Wage arrears of construction workers will also be affected. To get a better understanding of the payment practices of the local construction industry, the Development Bureau engaged a professional consultant to carry out a comprehensive and industry-wide survey in 2011 and a follow-up study in 2023. It was reviewed that the outstanding payment is as much as $10 billion every year. And that the stakeholders along the supply chain in the construction industry have been experiencing payment problems to different extents across the years. The average outstanding payment per annum accounted for 5% to 12% of the total business receipts, and the longest delay in payment was over 6 months and as long as 2 to 3 years in serious cases. The industry generally considered that there has been no noticeable improvement to the payment problems. Many countries, including Singapore, the UK, and Australia, have legislation on construction industry security of payment. Our bill has largely adopted the practice of these countries. In addition to drawing reference from overseas ordinances, we have taken into account views from local stakeholders. The Development Bureau set up a task force with major industry stakeholders in 2016, taking on board views collected from the public consultation in 2015 and taking forward legislation for the ordinance. After years of discussion, the industry has reached widespread consensus on the bill. Last November, we already consulted the relevant panel, and members expressed general support for the bill and called for legislation as early as possible. The bill mainly covers the following three salient points. 1. Improvement of contractual payment terms. The bill prohibits the use of unfair payment terms such as pay when paid, and imposes time limits for the paying party to give response to payment claims and make payment of the full amount that the paying party has submitted payable. 2. Both parties can still agree on terms in relation to the timetable and method of calculation in the contracts. That is, there is flexibility. And the prerequisite is that the basic legal requirements are not breached. Under these circumstances, they can still agree on the terms in relation to the timetable and calculation method in the contracts. 2. Moving on to the next point, establishing an adjudication mechanism to resolve disputes quickly. After the enactment of the bill, when a payment dispute arises, the claiming party is entitled to initiate the adjudication proceeding. The contracting parties can resolve the payment dispute through an independent adjudicator. That is, the adjudicator needs to have the relevant credentials and experience to solve the relevant payment disputes. The adjudicator must make the determination within 55 working days after the appointment. and the claimant can apply to a court an enforcement application to execute the adjudicator's determination. The adjudication we propose is mainly based on facts, including the relevant contractual terms, invoice, construction site surveying record, expert report, etc. It does not focus on legal basis or viewpoints. We hope this mechanism will take a shorter time than arbitration, as well as less costly. Usually, it takes about 3 months from starting an adjudication procedure to receiving payments about 3 months. That is the usual course of events. Furthermore, there is a mechanism under the bill to prevent any abuse of adjudication. For instance, if a claimant makes an application for adjudication without a reasonable likelihood of being ruled in favor, the adjudicator can make a determination such that the claimant is to pay a larger portion of adjudication fees. We will also formulate a code of practice inviting adjudicators to duly take into account the professional assessments of contract managers, such as engineers, architects, or surveyors, in the evaluation of grounds put forth. 3. Moving on to the suspension or slowing down of the progress, we allow the claiming party to suspend or slow down their progress of work. The proposed legislation will stipulate that under specified circumstances, including that 1. The paying party fails to pay to the claiming party the admitted amount in full or before the payable date, or 2. After the payment dispute is determined by adjudication, and the paying party fails to pay the adjudicated amount in full within the deadline, the claiming party is entitled to suspend or slow down the rate of progress of the works. The claiming party must inform the paying party and the owner at least 5 working days beforehand. The claiming party also needs to fully resume work within 5 working days after the receipt of the payment. That is a requirement stipulated under the bill. Regarding the applicability of the bill, save and except specified circumstances, the bill applies to contracts with the main contract values not less than the specified minimum contract values. That covers both private and public contracts. But regarding the requirement in relation to amounts, we propose a threshold of $5 million for carrying out construction work and $500,000 for contracts for the supply of goods, for example, materials and plant, as well as services related to the construction work. Considering that the general public may not be familiar with the construction contracts and relevant legislation, and it is difficult for them to comply with the requirements in the legislation, and the payment problems do not cover smaller scale of works, so we recommend that the bill does not cover indoor renovation, building maintenance, and so on. That is, in simpler terms, private contracts. They are not applicable to contracts for relatively minor works either. That is, those that do not have to be approved by the building authority, such as building, equipment, maintenance projects, as well as shop renovation, and so on. As the construction volume in Hong Kong will be maintained at a high level, it is the right time to bring forward the legislation to improve the delay payment problem in the industry. The industry has already reached a broad consensus on the major provisions of the bill. After the implementation of the bill, the situation of delay payments in the construction industry may improve. The project procurement cost may also reduce over time after the implementation of the bill, as price premiums risk in association with delay payments will decline following improved situation. The government will fully support the electrical's examination of the bill in the hope that the bill could be passed and implemented as early as possible. Better protection will be provided to stakeholders in the construction industry when it comes to receiving payments for their work in order to ensure the healthy and sustainable development of the industry. I so submit. Thank you, President. I now propose a question to you that the aforesaid bill be read the second time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
This Council resumes the second reading debate on the Dutiable Commodities Amendment Bill 2024.